हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल। आई एम आशीष एंड दिस वीडियो विल डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ फेस। व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट द एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बिकॉज इट इज आस्क्ड इन द शॉर्ट नोट्स एज वेल एज इन द लॉन्ग आंसर टाइप। सो दिस वीडियो इज द फर्स्ट इन द सीरीज। सो वी विल डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द फेस एज अ बेसिस एंड देन विल प्रोसीड फर्दर विद द ईच पार्ट ऑफ द फेस। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। तो ड्यूरिंग द फोर्थ अराउंड द फोर्थ वीक ऑफ इंट्रायूटराइन लाइफ देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए हेड फोल्ड एंड द टेल फोल्ड एंड इन द हेड फोल्ड रीजन वी हैव टू स्वेलिंग्स। एज यू नो द शेप ऑफ एम्ब्रियो लुक्स लाइक दिस। सो दिस फोल्ड अबव पोर्शन इज कॉल्ड द हेड फोल्ड एंड द लोअर पोर्शन इज कॉल्ड द टेल फोल्ड। सो द हेड फोल्ड शोज इटसेल्फ शोज टू स्वेलिंग्स दैट्स अराउंड द फोर्थ वीक। वन इज कॉल्ड द स्वेलिंग ड्यू टू द फ्रंट फोरब्रेन दैट इज अ डेवलपिंग फोरब्रेन एंड अदर इज कॉल्ड द पेरिकार्डियल स्वेलिंग। सो वी हैव गॉट टू स्वेलिंग नियर द हेड फोल्ड। द फर्स्ट वन इज ड्यू टू डेवलपिंग फोरब्रेन एंड सेकेंड वन इज ड्यू टू द डेवलपिंग पेरिकार्डियम रीजन विच इंक्लूड्स द डिफरेंट आर्टरीज एंड द वेनस ड्रेनेज that is developing into the future heart. So in the head fold we have got two folds. So this upper part that you see that is around the front of the forebrain, here is a mesenchyme. Okay, so in the front of the forebrain we have some mesoderm. So during this period there is a proliferation in the cells of the mesoderm. So the mesoderm number or the number of layers of the mesoderm increases and they show a downward projection. So you can see the mesoderm has projected downwards. So it is that was the mesoderm that was lying in the front of the this first bulge that was due to the developing forebrain. It has come down and covered the part of the stromatodium. So this is nothing but the this what is this? This is the foregut. This is the primitive foregut. This is the developing forebrain and this is the future pericardium or the pericardium and there is a process. You can see there is a formation of process which is called the frontonasal process. So if I ask you how frontonasal process is formed, it is due to the proliferation of the mesoderm lying the front of the bulge that was produced due to the developing forebrain. It has come down and covered the stromatodium portion and is called the frontonasal process. This is same the pericardial region and this is the foregut and this will be the buccopharyngeal membrane. All this I explained in the pharyngeal arches. You can have a look on that video in the embryology part. So you might be wondering why am I telling you for all these basics, but we have not discussed about the face yet. So let me tell you, this forms the basis of the development of the face. So if I say the face, development of face, what you should think? See, we have a number of structures in the face. What are they? Just you can recollect with me. We have eyes, we have nose, we have mouth, we have cheek, we have chin, we have forehead and other such part like the upper lip, lower lip, and that is further divided into some part. So we have a number of things in the face that is developed from a number of series of steps, and this really forms the basis of all the structure that are going to form in the future face. So we have got from the eye spaces, eye sockets, we have to form the nose means the nasal cavity, external nose and the lateral wall. We have got mouth, upper lip, lower lip, ear auricles and cheek and chin. So we'll see how they are formed. Okay, we have got the few things we have got frontonasal process by the fourth week and we have some pharyngeal arches. As you know, near the stromatodium region we have some arches which are called the pharyngeal arches or the brachiopharyngeal arches. So these arches extend from ventral to dorsal and meeting in the center portion. So it extends from dorsal to ventral in the medial side like this, on the merging in the center. So we have got branchial arches on the sides of the stromatodium which is going to form the future mouth. Okay, now you can guess one thing. What is that? All the structures of the face you develop from the structure or the primitive structure that are lying around the stomatodium, that is the pharyngeal arches, and the nearest to the stomatodium is the first branchial or the first pharyngeal arch, which is also called the mandibular arch. See, in total we have five arches. Okay, we have five persisting arches which are numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6. So we have got five arches. The first one has got special name, that is called the mandibular arch, and we have one more special name for one arch, that is called the hyoid arch. So we have got two special name for the remaining are called by just by the number. So we have got one special arch, that is called the mandibular arch, that form the first branchial arch. Purpose of telling all these things is that you should have an overview of all the structures that are going to be coming in the development of the face. So the very first structure that has come is the frontonasal process, formation of frontonasal process. Okay, the first structure that you come to know that will help in the development of the face is the structure near the stomatodium, and that is the frontonasal process. So now let us discuss the other diagram that will help you to develop our concept of the development of the face. So let me just introduce to our diagram. This, we have made a section like this. Okay, we have made a section like this. So we have got in this diagram, we have made a section like this. So we have got what? This is the frontonasal process. Frontonasal process. This is the mandibular arch over here. This is the mandibular arch, that is the first branchial or the first pharyngeal arch, and this is the future pericardium, or this portion. Okay, so this is the future pericardium. Now what happens, we have got, now you can easily tell, for the development of the face we need five structures. Face develops from five primordial structure. The first one is the frontonasal process, which is unpaired, that is, we have a single frontonasal process, and we have two paired structure, that is the mandibular arch. Okay, that I will tell you later. Just you have a look on the diagram first. See, we have got frontonasal process, we have got mandibular arch and the pericardium. What happens, this mandibular arch on its dorsal side, see this arch, the arch we have over here. So suppose this is the arch. Okay, this is the arch. Imagine it is U-shaped. So this is the ventral side and this is the dorsal side. Okay, what happens, near the dorsal side there comes a process from the mandibular arch. So this is the main body of the mandibular arch, and from its dorsal side there comes a process which is called the maxillary process. This is called maxillary process. And the remaining part or the main body of the mandibular arch forms the mandibular process. So what happens, near the dorsal end of the mandibular arch there comes a bud which forms the maxillary process, and these all processes are trying to approach in the center. So you can see these processes will appear like this and trying to approach in the center part. So in the future you will see that they are approaching and forming the parts of the rest part of the face, that we will see in the next video. See, if the question is asked of the development of the face in the short notes, then this video is sufficient. But at this video plus the pinnacle is sufficient, but if it has been long, you have to watch the rest of the videos, then only your answer will be called sufficient. So we have got maxillary process from the main mandibular arch, the dorsal side there is a bud called the maxillary process, and we have the mandibular process as well, which is the primitive old body of the mandibular arch. Now you can see face is developed from five primordial structure, that we have got frontonasal process which is unpaired, we have got maxillary process, and we have got mandibular process and maxillary. These two are paired. Okay, so we have got, that is, in total two maxillary, two mandibular and one frontonasal, in total five. So you've got the five structure that is going to form the face of the human body. Now we will see what all structure these three processes or the these three structure, primordial structure, are going to arise. First we'll learn about the structures and then we'll discuss about the each structure in detail in the upcoming videos. So this table is itself sufficient to tell about all the development of the phase in just a brief. So we have got five processes, that is frontonasal process, which is unpaired. We have got maxillary process, which is, and mandibular process, which are paired. So in total we have got five process. Now how this process developed? See, the frontonasal process developed from the mesoderm that lie ventrally in the front of the developing forewing, as we discussed in the previous diagram. So as you saw, the mesenchyme lying in front of the developing forebrain forms the frontonasal process. And by that time, you know that the mandibular process and the maxillary process are developed from the first branchial arch. Now there is a point to tell you in this. See, suppose this is an arch. Suppose this is arch. So arch runs in the medial part of the base of the pharynx, that is the future pharynx, and from dorsal to ventral side. So this is the dorsal portion and this is the ventral portion. So the dorsal portion forms the mandibular part, that is the dorsal portion forms the maxillary part and the ventral portion forms the mandibular part. So this is the mandibular part and the remaining here on the sides we have the maxillary part. And these are the arches are nothing but the mesoderm. So maxillary process is formed by the mesoderm of the dorsal part of the first branchial arch, and mandibular process formed by the mesoderm of the ventral part of the first branchial arch. So this thing I think is very clear to you. Now the relation to the stomatodium. As you know, all the structures of the face will develop from the structure that are near to the stomatodium. So stomatodium has got two borders. We have got upper border and a lower border. This is the upper border and this is the lower border. In the upper border, in the center, we have one part, or the middle we have one part, that is called the frontonasal part, and other are the side we have the maxillary, and the lower part we have the mandibular. So these are the relations of the these three processes in relation to the stomatodium. So above the or the upper border of stomatodium, what we have, suppose this is the stomatodium. In the upper border we have, in the middle we have the frontonasal process, in the later part we have the maxillary, and down we have the, or in the lower border we have the mandibular process. So this thing you should write in your answer sheet. Now let's see what all structures are formed by each process. So for remembering, this is quite headache for you, so let me just simplify and tell. See, the mandibular and the maxillary part will form the structure that are near to the mouth. Okay, suppose these are the eyes, the nose, and here we have got the mouth. So maxillary and mandibular will form the structure that are near to the mouth, this region. So in this region, what structure we have? We have cheek, we have chin, we have lips, that is upper lip and the lower lip. So these three structures, or these structures, are formed by the maxillary and the mandibular, and rest all above structures are formed by the frontonasal process. That is, we have the forehead, external nose, nasal cavity and the nasal septum. That is, you can say near about whole nose is formed by the frontonasal process. And we have got philtrum. What is philtrum? See, this is the upper lip. Suppose this is the upper lip and this is the lower lip. Okay, so in the upper lip, in the center position, you might see a ridge over here. I think it's, you might know this, this is called the philtrum. This philtrum is formed by the frontonasal process that lie in the center part near the opening of the mouth. That's the primitive stomatodium. Now the rest of the part, that is the lateral part of the upper lip, okay, and the later part of upper lip and the upper part of the cheek, this region is formed by the maxillary process. And what about the remaining middle portion of the upper lip? That is formed by the frontonasal process lying in the mid portion. Then lower lip is formed by the mandibular region. And what we have chin over here, that is also formed by the mandibular process. In the upper part of the cheek lie in the maxillary part, but the lower part of the cheek lie in the mandibular part. As you know, trigeminal nerve, that the fifth cranial nerve, has got three division: maxillary, mandibular, and the ophthalmic. Ophthalmic lie near the eye region, maxillary near the, that's the near the nasal nasal region or the upper part of the mouth, and mandibular near the lower part of the mouth. So the ophthalmic division supply all the frontonasal process except the philtrum. So this is commonly asked, this question is commonly asked by the examiner to confuse you. He will ask which of the structure formed by the frontonasal process is supplied by the maxillary nerve. So you should tell the philtrum or the central part of the upper lip. Now the rest of the maxillary process is formed by the maxillary nerve, and the mandibular process are all innervated by the mandibular nerve, that is the V3 or the third division of the trigeminal nerve. So this was the first video in the section. So I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please hit the like button and do subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.